Opinions matter.
Opinions matter.
Opinions matter.
Yo, welcome to another episode of your favorite podcast, Opinions Matter. I'm your boy, K. Foye.
I'm the Haroun McCadney.
Leon Keys.
Donald Keys.
Leon.
Hey.
Watch your mouth.
Thanks again for joining us for another episode. We know you could have been any place in the world, but you chose to be here with us, and we appreciate it, all right? Hey, today we got an action-packed show for you guys, all right? We're going to do our segment. We brought back our segment called The Grind, where we shout out entrepreneurs across the country. All right, we have a new segment called Social Media, where we pick one or two videos, popular videos in social media, and we give you our reaction to those videos. And again, we got those hard-hitting topics that we always have, right, fellas?
Yep.
All right, so as we always do, all right, what's been going on since last episode, Haroun?
I was on vacation the last time, okay. So, went on a 7-day cruise with the family.
Yeah, 7-day cruise and 4 pitches. So he posted 4 pictures.
I don't think he went.
First
of all, he was going on your own vacation.
Downtown Norfolk in Wisconsin.
Hey, look, he had a green screen.
Go on your own vacation, take your own damn picture. Man, don't be living through me. Don't be living through me. Hell, both of you. Anyway, but I had a vacation. We had a good time.
Okay.
So,
you and the family, the whole family went?
No, my wife, my son, a couple of cousins. Okay. You know, it was like 50 of us.
Hey, that's what's up.
Yeah, man.
Where are your pictures?
Hey, look.
Wait, no.
Oh, my gosh. Get your own passport. Go on your own vacation.
I just asked the question. Why I have got to be attacked, man?
Donald.
The camera malfunction.
Yeah.
In other words, go on your own vacation.
No, but seriously, though.
Man,
you had a good time?
It was a good time, man. That's good. I mean, I'm never taking that drive to Fort Lauderdale.
Yeah, that was a long drive. I did it before.
And then,
the drive there wasn't bad. I mean, the drive there was, a little rough, but once you get off the ship, man,
right,
like,
that's it.
Oh, man, we got to take that drive home.
Yeah.
Stop being cheap and play for a plane ticket.
We had a ball, everything. And Kim is not allowed to sit in my chair no more.
Oh, okay.
So, come on, man.
She can sit in your chair.
Can't sit in my chair.
No, they did a good job, though. So that's good. To Z and Kim.
That's what's up. So, Don, what's been up with you, man?
Hey, look, man, tell nobody, but I'm going to tell everybody on my pennies, man. Okay. I hit the lottery, man.
You hit the lottery?
Yeah.
Won
that mega jump?
You won $2?
Yeah, no. Free ticket.
Free ticket.
It's been working, man. That's it, working, man.
How's the new job going?
It's going. And I like it, I ain't gonna say better than the last one, but I missed the cats at the last job.
Right.
But I'm getting paid now.
More money, right? You can always get new friends.
Right,
and look, you can always get new work friends.
Oh no.
If the money's good, you can always get new work
friends. No,
yeah, you can always get them.
Go ahead, man.
Yeah, man.
Man,
I've been chilling, man.
Being petty.
Been on our entrepreneurial thing, man. What I'm saying? Been on the grind.
Can I stop you right now?
Go ahead.
If you take another picture behind my truck, again, you're
going to
have problems.
Hey, man. Hey, look, like I said, I've been on my entrepreneurial grind, man, trying to get the word out, everybody needs to, make sure you invest in yourself every day. Not just daily, but, every day. Every day you need to do something for yourself or for your own brand, man. Because, we go into work, clock in 8, 12. Some people work in 16-hour shifts, man, for somebody else. Mm-hmm. Why can't you put at least an hour a day into your own self?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah. Absolutely.
Tap into that hidden talent, So that's what I've been trying to do. Yes. Motivate. Elevate.
On the grind, bro.
I got something.
On
the grind, man. I got something else, too.
What's up, man? You already had your time, man.
Look, it's back. Look. Y'all ain't saying nothing.
Anyway,
y'all made a big deal when I learned I cut it. Oh, you talk mess about me. But now
did,
I got
we
it
did,
back.
We
you
did.
Know, uh-huh.
It grew back pretty fast, like a chia pet, man. You grew back pretty fast, man. But check it, man. Hey, look, Hey, I'm glad y'all been doing well, man.
Petty.
Now we're going into our segment called The Grind, all right? During The Grind, we shout out entrepreneurs. I don't care where you at, right? If you want to be shouted out during the segment of The Grind for what you're doing, give some marketing, some free marketing to your business, just let us know. Hit us up on email, comment on this actual YouTube video, comment here, like, share, all that good stuff. We got you, all right? I promise you that, all right? So I want to shout out a gentleman, man, named Antonio Starr. He is the CEO of First Generation Millionaire Clothing. And I'm telling you, man, this guy is on fire, man. He's a best-selling author. He just wrote a book that you all can get out there right now. I will drop the name of his book here shortly. But he has a clothing line, and he's also part of our online shopping club team as well, man. So hey, if you ever want to get motivated by someone, Antonio Starr is that guy. I'm telling you right now. All right, Haroun, who you got?
I got two. My first is my niece Shimon Gayton. She has a website called Payfair.com, and what it is she does graphic design, artwork. Okay. Album covers. She's also a photographer.
Okay.
So she does photos, and she's a tattoo artist.
Yeah.
Where's she at? Goes by. Oh, she's in Atlanta.
Oh.
Is she a Jamaican? She got a lot of jobs.
Hey man, she's got a line, man.
That's a good thing.
She got a website and all that.
Yeah. Payfair.com.
Can she do cover up tattoos?
Yeah.
Cause he got a tattoo right at the back of his neck. He need to have covered up.
And also, she's also a recording artist as well.
Man, stop, man. I'm trying to be serious.
All right, man. Go ahead. Also, she's a recording artist as well. So,
oh, okay.
So she has a new single.
She's singing a rap.
She sings.
Okay.
Rap. She does both. She's Jamaican.
Yeah, so I will give you the.
Okay.
Once the song is ready, man, we got to play it on our.
We
podcast.
Will. We will.
Also, another cousin of mine named Maya Hall, she has a production company called Three Pyramids. She's also doing TV. Videos. Her son Mark Ryan, he's a recording artist as well. So she's promoting his songs as well. So
what's up, man?
Yeah, man, so all your cousins are Jamaican, man. They got all kind of jobs, man.
Yeah, she's former Army, retired Army. She went from that transition to doing production and TV music production.
Wow. And they all seem talented. Where's your talent?
What's up? Okay.
All right. Hey.
Sure.
Hey.
Hey, this is a family show, so I'm not gonna say what I really want to say to them. But
if y'all want to get in contact with any of those entrepreneurs that we just shouted out during The Grind, all right, check us out on our Facebook, YouTube, Instagram, all that Twitter account. We will shout out there. We'll give you the information. We'll give you a link also to their websites. All right, all right. So we want to appreciate y'all. Appreciate those people. For being shouted out on The Grind. All right. So our next segment, this is a new segment that we're doing right now. Right?
Okay. Mm-hmm.
We're doing social media, what we call it, right? So we're going to pick one or two videos every time we shoot, and highlight those videos. So today we got two videos. Mm-hmm. Uh-huh. So one of them, our first video is from the show, I'm not sure if y'all watch it, called The Four. All right. That show is with, I think it has Puff Daddy, DJ Khaled, and Trainer, she's a singer or whatever. There was a 17-year-old singer up there last week, who blew everybody away. All right, so I want y'all to check this out. This video has gotten at least 3 million hits on social media, so we're gonna check that out together, right, fellas?
Okay.
Because I know y'all don't have cable, so hey, check this out.
You stay paid, right. Man. Stay paid.
Catch
him
on back.
All right, y'all gotta listen to this voice, man. For real, she is incredible.
You look like your daughter, man. You trying to give a shout out to your.
Said I didn't feel nothing, baby, but I lied.
Hey,
look at who she sounds like.
She sounds like that Ava.
Yeah. I wish just another big star.
No.
Yeah, no.
I haven't really heard anybody sound just exactly like her. Because I buy her music right now.
No, she does sound like. She has similarities
to her. I mean, she's only 17 years old. That's my thing. 17 years old.
what, man? Shows like this, like you said, often we said before, man, sometimes they have the best.
Yeah, right, right. I think it's a popularity contest somewhere. But for this one right here, for her, I mean, it's by her talent. Like, she, I would hope so. Yeah, she can have her up and sing. There's a lot of talent out there.
Who is that?
They got a rap girl on there, man, too. She has cancer. Yeah, she's tight. She's tight, though. We're going to look at one of her videos. Look at that. Yeah, very talented.
I live through social media.
Yeah, right. And I started watching this because of her. You know, whenever you get a standing ovation, you're done. And again, she only 17 years old.
She go up there.
Puppy said he ready to sign her right now.
Don't sign for Puppy. Hey, wait a minute.
Don't talk nothing bad about Puppy. AKA Sean Diddy Combs. Alright. Alright, so the next video we're gonna watch. So everybody's seen the lip sync challenges.
No.
Not Kiki. Not the Shiggy challenge.
Oh, okay, you talking about.
But this one is from the police departments around the country. So the ladies one is from the Greensboro, North Carolina Police Department. Alright? Where they did Summertime. All right, let's listen to the song Summertime. So let's check that one out real quick.
I'm Cindy Farmer here with Greensboro Police Chief Wayne Scott. And Chief, this has been the summer where a lot of police agencies across the nation have stepped up as goodwill ambassadors.
I think it was really to promote the police department. Because, you know, it was so much
negativity,
right? It's just a way to see, to make them seem human to me. And I think it worked.
Well,
so first of all, see, they're illegal. So you really can't do it. They shut Greensboro down into this.
As far as their reputation.
I think
it gives a little bit.
Yeah,
it needs a little bit more rhythm.
Nobody got no rhythm on here. Just a little something to break. Okay. She doing her thing. The police chief right there behind us.
Yeah, he's right behind us.
Look at this. Look at the old cheerleaders. But again, no rhythm in the whole Greensboro. To me, Norfolk had a great one. Norfolk had the most rhythm too.
This is the only one I've seen at length.
3 minutes worth of taxpayers' money, man. I mean, I'm sure it took them a lot. Norfolk said they did this in one take.
I don't know about that.
Let that go again.
You just finished wiping your car down. It's time to cruise.
so you go to the summertime, hang out at the car show. Look at them, fresh from the barbershop, fly in the beauty salon. Probably, man. They use, I mean, they use what's called everything, though. They use drones and everything. He said they ain't sent him his check yet.
They ain't sent him his check yet.
Oh yeah.
Yeah. But they ain't do that.
Nah, they ain't do none of that.
They call Will. That's pretty cool. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's pretty cool.
Yeah. Just a little something, man. You know. Yeah. Next time we got a couple more videos, man. We're gonna try not to show like some of the fight videos, but some of them been funny lately. You saw the one from McDonald's?
Oh, the girl. She
wasn't ready for.
She wasn't ready for what's the name?
Big Bertha.
Big
she Bertha. She wasn't ready.
What's that her name?
What was Cole's girl name? Big Shirley. Big Shirley. She wasn't ready for Big Shirley.
Big Shirley put them hands on.
Quick.
Don't nobody else.
So hey, if you enjoyed that, please comment down in the comment section, all right? Let us know if you want to see a video on here that you want us to review as well, all right? Uh-huh. We'll be right back with the next segment. Stay tuned. I never give it mercy. Murder, she knows. I never give it mercy.
Yeah, we are. Don't nobody really say that anymore. Get twisted. Look, every beat I'm on, I never give it mercy. Like an alpha, the flow's ice cold. The flow H2O if you're thirsty. Every bar I spit suit your soul like murder, she hold. If you're talking about appropriation, the whole nation guilty by association. This whole system needs exfoliation. You keep commandments, but you devilish. So really, you a holy saint. How you Muslim, but you roll with bacon? Hell, I ain't Muslim, I'm just saying. If you acting, that's the role you playing. Don't judge me, you need to listen. Hell, I'm approaching 30, that's when all that lay whipping stops. Don't get it twisted, I'm with God until the ticket stops. But anybody could catch these hands like...
All right, welcome back. Welcome back to the next to the next segment of Opinions Matter. All right, and so let's do a recap real quick. So the last segment, we talked about social media. We talked about... we shouted out some entrepreneurs, all right?
Uh-huh.
All right, so this segment, all right, we're going to talk about a few topics, fellas.
All right.
Are y'all ready?
Yeah, let's go.
The first topic we're going to talk about is the support of your friends and family when you're trying to start a business or trying to do something good.
Mm-hmm.
All right? So, this is what I've seen. And even with our business Opinions Matter, right?
Yep.
Right now we have about 200 subscribers on YouTube. We have about maybe eight, nine comments when we put something on our Facebook page or whatever. And my thing is this. I know I have over, like, I think it's 500 friends on Facebook. And usually I don't accept anybody that I don't interact with, mm-hmm. usually. So to me, right, I should have at least 600 subscribers for our page.
Mm-hmm.
At least. I think we probably have about 30 or 40 friends in common, mm-hmm. on Facebook, but at least go to my page, check me out, check us out, support what we're trying to do as we're trying to build. But I do see a lot of that. I think a lot of people, a lot of your friends and a lot of your family don't support you when you're trying to make that come up, as they say. And does that, if they don't support you, do you need to change your friend circle? Or do you just chalk it up as, okay, they're not going to be on my team, I'm going to need to do something different? How do you feel about that?
Man, I don't know, man. I mean, that's, you know, I know how I am.
Right.
You know, and I try to, you know, to support those. And I don't really expect anything in return, but I'm like, if you
do. I do.
I mean... to a certain level. Right. I mean, but, like, for example, you know, I got family who are, you know, doing, you know, certain things, you know, and you try to show them the same support.
Right.
You know, you patronize their product or whatever. And you would hope when it's your turn that they would do the same. You know, don't always get that. You know, and I
I said, all right, you know, that's cool. And I just leave him alone after that. But at least you know that I was there when you needed me, you know. But everybody doesn't have that same mentality that I have.
So at what point do you, because sometimes you outgrow some friends. Sometimes you outgrow. But those friends who you talk to on a regular basis, who you, you know, like you say, who you support, should you be, feel some kind of way if they don't support you?
I do. What you're trying to do? Of course. Like you just said, you got how many people that you know?
Right.
You know, I'm the same. I feel the same way. You know, I got not only friends, but all, you know, I got a big family.
Mm-hmm.
And you would think for the most part, if your friends don't show you support, that at least your family would.
Right.
And you turn around and you're like, damn, they're not supporting me either.
Right.
So, I mean, if it's something negative, and that's the thing, man. If it's something negative, everybody's on board with it. Even, you know, friends and family, something negative, they got something to talk about, something bad. But the minute that you do something that is productive and you do something that's
positive,
you know, positive.
Mm-hmm.
You know, a lot of times you don't get that support. You know,
right.
I can tell you, as far as like all of our podcasts that we've done, you know, up to this one,
right.
I got probably
you can
10 or 15, maybe 20 of my friends and family that religiously watch it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I'm like, why only 20?
Right.
And I always say that, why only 20? And
you know, I know people busy.
And it's frustrating though because
I get it.
Yeah, because it's not like what we're doing takes a lot of time out of your life to show support and to just patronize it, subscribe to it, and let some people know, especially the people that we have shouted out on our page.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Shouted out on our podcast.
Right.
Even those people sometimes don't, you know, return the favors. Like, oh man, my cousin's doing this. Hey man, he shouted me out. Okay, well look, I'm gonna get some people to please come in and check out what it is that he's doing.
Right.
You know, you don't get that, man, and it's frustrating, man.
But yeah, I say, look, like at minimum, right? You can at least go subscribe to the page, even if you never watch another show.
Mm-hmm.
Right. At least check it out one time. Subscribe to it. Comment. Leave us a comment if you don't like it. Let us know what you want to see different.
Sure.
We'll definitely change it, right? And also share with your, you know, share with somebody.
Yeah.
Share with just one person. That junk goes a long way. And not just us, but it's everybody that's doing something out there positive, everybody that's doing something that's worthwhile. Support your people, man, because if we don't support each other, nobody else will do it in the first place.
Okay, you just said something about, like, when have you outgrown? You want to answer that?
What's you do
that?
Well?
When do you... When
outgrow
you,
your friends, yeah. Yeah, sometimes you do.
Yeah. I mean, when do you know that?
I think you know it, man, when you're trying to elevate yourself and your friends are staying at that same level,
mm-hmm.
right? And I think at that point, you do outgrow them. If they're not elevating you, if they're not trying to add something to what you're trying to do, then basically, man, you don't have time for foolishnesses anymore.
What you think about that?
I got an example.
Yeah.
You know, I just started a new job with the VA.
Right.
A friend of my old childhood friend, he's working there. Okay. So he's out on medical, whatever. So he's asking me, texting me, saying, what shift you on? And I was like, I'm on evening 2 to 11.
Right.
He was like, oh, nah, you need to get on the morning shift, blah, blah, blah. And I was like, basically, why? And his response is, that's what all the women are. That's what blah, blah, blah. And I hit him back. I texted him back. I said, yo, we looking for different stuff. We on a different level. Because I'm about money. It's evening shift, you get the differential. And the weekend, you get the weekend.
Right.
I said, some female, that ain't got nothing to do with my money.
Right.
You know, I'm trying to get paid, not get laid.
Yeah.
Simple as that. And I right there in the new, and I thought, said to myself, I was like, we going different directions.
Yeah.
You know, cool, but
yeah,
can't do it.
My point is, man, at some point, right, when you get a certain age, life is all about, it has to be about what you can do, not just for you, but for your seeds,
yeah,
you know,
exactly.
To give them as time goes along, right? And my thing is, it's all about different revenue streams. Mm-hmm. You gotta have, like, at our age, man.
Yeah.
Even when you're coming up, I teach my daughter, you gotta have multiple outlets of money coming in. Because suppose just one, like, we saw it, if you lose your job, right, your main job, if you lose that, do you have any other money coming in besides this? Mm-hmm. And that's the way I look at it. It took me a while for it to click. Mm-hmm. But you gotta have another way that you can support yourself or your family.
And you know what? Talking about when you outgrow someone, I remember when I left here in 2000, I believe, and I was gone for 8 years.
Right.
And, you know, I came back home.
You know, I was going to say, you know, when you left, Hampton really flourished, man.
Yeah, right.
Go ahead.
Anyway.
So you left and came back.
Anyway, like I said, it better be happy that we're on a PG show. But anyway, I left, and when I came back, and you run into people,
right?
You run into people, and they still doing the same thing.
Yep.
And they're not
same old
they're
thing.
Doing
man.
The same old thing that they were when you left, and you're like, dude,
bruh.
Come on, man, we're 8 years older.
Right.
Exactly. A lot of us were already married, and a lot of us had kids, and even those particular people. They had children, and they were, like, just still standing around.
Not going to hit the club every night.
They out the club. Oh, man, I'm about to go out tonight. What you doing? Yeah, come on, man. I got time for that.
Yeah.
So there is a point where I think for a lot of us, though, we don't see it early on. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And you can see the people. And sometimes you know, even as far back as high school, who was going to be doing this.
Yeah.
And this and this and how they're going to wind up. Sometimes you know, and you want to, you know, be a loyal friend, and you want to be somebody that has always got somebody's back. But then you have to, you know, take a step back and look and like.
I think we waste a lot of time too.
Yeah, that's a waste of time
and effort, man, in doing things that you look back on it like, I wasted 5 years of my time when I could have been doing this, and I could have had, you know, this much.
I can admit
in that. You know what I'm saying?
I can admit that. I think for me, I wasted a lot of time.
Yeah.
You know, and...
But it's never too late.
Right.
Right?
But
it's always...
But when hindsight being 2020, you know, I had other opportunities.
Right.
You know, when I lived in North Carolina, when I lived here, that I could have done something. And I'm like, I'm not thinking...
Not thinking that way.
I'm thinking, you know, my mindset was different then.
Yeah.
And so...
I think a lot of our mindsets, because... Our parents taught us, get a 9-to-5 job, you go in there, you punch the clock, and that's the way your life is supposed to be. If you have a job, you're making money, you're taking care of your family. But these days, I think it calls for another step up. You know, we have to change our mentality, and it has to be a way where you know, it just can't be that clocking in every day. You got to have another revenue stream that will allow you to make money and support just in case this one goes down.
Okay, well, let me ask you a question.
Yeah.
And you know what we're doing here,
mm-hmm.
and the other stuff that we're doing together.
Right.
How many? Just a ballpark figure.
Uh-huh.
How many people that you spoke have you told that we told about what it is that we're doing?
Mm-hmm.
How many people can you say are on board with what we're doing?
Man,
I'm asking both of you this question.
Right.
Can you give an estimate of how many people...
And on board, you mean that are there supporting us?
Yeah, supporting you.
Probably like 50. Between us all.
Oh, between us all.
There you go.
Probably like 50 between us all.
Yeah.
But you know what, though? The good thing about it is sometimes those no's, and when you get those doors slammed and you get those people that don't support you, it's supposed to fuel you. Right.
Yeah, but you know, it starts so frustrating at times.
Yeah, it is frustrating.
Because we go on Facebook and on our Facebook page and we post stuff, great topics. And only like 6 or 7 people or 8 people, 10
it's
people.
It's always the same people.
Though. Yeah, always post the same. Yeah. But you post a fight video.
Yeah.
World Star.
Yeah.
I mean, I hate to say it, but.
Kiki Challenge.
Yeah, I mean.
I've gotten to the point, though, and maybe I shouldn't feel this way. But I got to the point where, you know, when we do get put out new content and stuff, and I put it out there, I can guarantee you, I know the people who are going to watch it.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I can tell you, it's probably 10 to 20, like I said before, that are actually
religiously watching it.
But then those other 400 or 500, they want you to promote something for them.
Mm-hmm.
But when we ask for the support, they don't get it.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
And but that's the point that I'm like, all right, man, look, if I do this for you, you know, how come you can't do that for me? You know, like I said, I got a lot of family in Philadelphia. I got a lot of family in South Carolina. I got all these people out here. And it's like, and I look at our subscribers, I'm like,
yeah, man, it's different. It's different ways, though. And you know, once one way doesn't work, man, you know, I think it's up to us to determine another way to do it. But hey, check this out. Hey, if you are watching this video, right, and you are friends on Facebook, support your boys, right? Support what we're doing. I guarantee you, when we blow up, we'll support your back. I promise you that. We won't forget about the little people.
Right? I'm not supporting. I'm telling you right now.
All right, I'm
petty.
And we'll be right back with our final segment on Opinions Matter. Segment, we give our opinions on a variety of topics. All right, he may not agree with what I say, but that's why it's called just my opinion, because it's my opinion. All right, I'm gonna go first, fellas, as I always do, because I always have the best things to say. Y'all agree?
Best of the worst.
All right, so
shut
them
down.
So hey, I wanted to talk about what we've been talking about the last couple of segments, and it's promoting your brand. All right, every individual has their own brand. All of them have their, every individual has a hidden talent, right? What you have to do is tap into that talent, all right, and do what you do to promote that talent and make a revenue stream off of that talent. We all can do it, okay? We have to support each other when we're doing it, and I guarantee you, if you do that, if you focus on whatever it is that you do best, you will be successful, all right? Success is out there waiting on everybody. All you got to do is knock on the door. Sometimes you have to knock down the door. All right?
Yep.
Don't quit. Somebody tells you no, use that as fuel. And that's just my opinion, fellas.
Yep. Uh-huh.
All right?
Jerry Jones came out with the statement that everybody on his team was told, will not be in the locker room, will stand for the anthem, and you will be on the field to toe the line.
Toe the line.
Also, he said he's not going to sever any ties with Papa John's.
Right.
Because they have ownership stake in Papa John's in Dallas area or whatever.
Mm-hmm.
My thing is this, and his buddy tweeted, way to go, Jerry. His buddy being 45.
45. DT.
I'm going to say this to end this. Y'all keep hollering, we the boys. Watching the Dallas Cowboys, buying all this paraphernalia. Keep doing it.
We know where they stand at right now.
Yep. I mean, keep buying his Cowboy stuff and posting it all over your Facebook and following these. You're no better than 45 and his supporters.
Mm.
That's all I got to say on that.
Oops, alrighty. Hey, if you don't agree with Donald, comment on this.
There's a lot of people coming out.
I don't care. I mean, the truth is truth. I mean, come on now.
My thing is on this is school's about to start for these little young kids
out
here.
It is.
And the one thing your kids need more than anything is support from your parents. So I implore everyone to just keep an eye on what your kids are watching, keep an eye on what they're doing. You are the last line of defense on what's going on out here. So, as school begins, and you know, me being a father of a fourth grader now, you know, I see how he's progressing, and I see what he's exposed to, And if I can see it, I'm quite sure that all these parents who are sitting around here letting their kids do whatever, I know they can. Yeah. You just got to choose to do something about it.
That's true.
All right? So for me, just show your kids support. Show these schools support. These teachers need your help in helping guide these kids to be successful. And you can't depend on just the teacher. You have to do what it is that you need to do in order for your kids to succeed. So that's it.
Hey, fellas. Another good segment, fellas.
Shout out.
All right. Shout outs to everybody, man. I mean, everybody who supports Opinions Matter. We want to give you all a shout out, man. No matter what, my boy DJ Pace, especially, who's up in the D.C. area, he comments on all of our videos. He gives me constructive feedback, gives us constructive feedback. No matter what, we appreciate the love, DJ.
Oh, yeah. I got to give a shout out to my man, Curtis Irving. And Kurt is an Army veteran, retired. He suffers from PTSD, and what he's doing, and look, everything is not about a paycheck. You know, this guy's doing this because it's something he's passionate about, but he is opened up a few group homes recently.
Okay.
For real?
Yeah.
Okay.
And so for any veterans who need a place to stay.
We'll get his information.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Hit up Kurt. Like I said, he's running three. He hit me up the other day about it. He's like, look, at least I told him I shout it out for you, man. That,
okay.
So if any veterans who are suffering or who need a place to stay, you know, hit Curtis up, and we'll have his information for you. But I got to give a shout out for him because, you know, he's doing good things, you know. And again, it's not always about, you know, how much money you make. It's about helping people at times. And he's, you know, something that he's passionate about, something he suffers from.
Mm-hmm.
And so he can relate. And, oh, my bad. But,
okay.
You know, so shout out to Kurt.
And again, shout out to the official sponsor, all right, of Opinions Matter. All right, Circle Snack Bar and Grill. The owner, my man Vic, we appreciate you and what you're doing to support our project that we have going on here. Hey, and as always, family, all right, we may not be experts about everything, right? But we may not be experts about anything, but we have opinions about everything. Until next time.
Peace out. Peace. Peace. Yeah. Get twisted, Sundays. Look. Two things my mama want me never to do is steal or get dropped. Yup, my partners got it out the mud, so they rock bands like Slipknot. Maybe Kid Rock. Either way it go, they show they getting guap. Why? Because they dropped up out of school and rock some juice to cover what tuition costs.